If all you have is a 3D printer, every problem starts looking like a print. But plastic isn't always the answer. Sometimes, the best way to print a complex mechanism is to not print it at all. I'm Salveo, and this is your daily dose of functional printing. When you are printing springs, you have to consider one important variable: time. Let's look at the evidence. This is a fresh print. You compress it and snaps back to its original shape. We can now compare it with the same spring that was kept compressed for just 12 hours. And we've already lost some travel. This is called creep. Ideally, a spring should return to its original shape. But plastic has bad memory. Under constant stress, over time, the molecules slide to relieve the pressure, and the spring dies. Steel, however, keeps the tension. So instead of fighting physics, let's go hybrid. So here's the challenge. I'm designing a rugged case for my Mac Mini. I need a secure locking mechanism, but I want to avoid bulky external latches. The solution is an internal spring-loaded catch. But as we've seen, printing the spring is not an option anymore. Instead, we can integrate a standard 15mm binder clip to handle the tension, knowing it will always spring back. Here's the final prototype of the mechanism. But before the snap, let's see how we got here. I don't want this video to turn into a CAD lesson, so I'll fast forward to the final model. I modeled the latch in a slightly over-rotated position. You can see here that the hook overlaps with the shell wall. And that's intentional. It forces the steel clip to push past its resting position. So even when the box is locked, the clip is trying to rotate further, creating a constant preload that pushes the hook tight against the upper shell. Now it's time to print the first draft and see if anything works. Let's assemble V1. We start by removing one handle and sliding the clip into the frame. Turns out that the hole left by the wire is a perfect fit for a piece of filament. That's what we'll use as a pin. Once the clip is in place, we can slide the latch in. I can already feel the springiness of the binder clip through the part. We assemble the rest and, yeah, as usual, the first try doesn't snap freely. The hook goes in, but the clearance is too tight and creates too much friction. So back to the CAD, I enlarged the tolerance and found the sweet spot at 0.3mm offset. Let's try the new part and... V1 works. The core concept is validated. But if you're like me, you know the final design is always the next one. The main thing I wanted to fix is that I don't want to manually push the latch to close it. I need a geometry that auto-closes when the top shell is pressed on. You can see how the latch curves internally to engage with the top shell. Now that we've achieved the auto-closure, we can step it up and try this on an actual enclosure. I really like the snappy closing action and the overall clean look I achieved. It's not perfect yet, it still has some drawbacks, like needing access from the outside for the pivot screw. But I'm satisfied with the result. It's a solid starting point for the Mac Mini project. I think this binder clip implementation has a lot of potential use cases. It could even be a really nice tactile button or anything that needs a firm, reliable spring return. I've left the parametric fusion file free for everyone in the description. You can modify the box footprint with just one click. If you want to see more functional printing and less plastic waste, consider subscribing. We have a lot more to build together. See you on the next one. Ciao.